Welcome to the Hour of Hope with Pastor Chioma Emmanuel, where God will give you beauty for ashes, joy for mourning, praise for despair, an answer to your prayer. For your expectation of a good future will not be cut off. And now, here is your host, Pastor Chioma Emmanuel, with today's message.
Hello, welcome again to another Hour of Hope. My name is Chioma Emmanuel. God bless you. Before we go on into today's message, I would like us to pray. Father, Lord, I thank you, great and mighty God, that bring your praises this time, O Lord. Father, I pray that you saturate the atmosphere, Lord Jesus. Grant me unction to unction, O Lord. And grant me the word, O Lord, to declare over your people. And Lord, give them a listening ear. And Father, Lord, I pray that your word will go forth, O Lord, and accomplish its purpose. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. We thank God for today. We bless God for today. I thank God for what He's going to do. And I thank God for each one of you. Today I just want to preach to somebody who has been in a situation for some time, crying, every time crying. Somebody who has been facing challenges in life, who has been facing things that saying that I don't know where to turn to. Child of God, I have a good news for you. The good news I have for you today is that I know that we serve a God who makes a way. If you keep crying, what happened? You bring sickness, you bring pain, you bring everything. But I thank God that this time is called Hour of Hope. I want to take you into a man who is called Joseph, who went through pains in his life, who was once in a time in his life was a crying man, you know, because of the household wickedness, because of the accusation, because of the things he went through in life. You know, he was crying anywhere he goes. You know, he will face something that will make him to cry. His own brother sold him and threw him into Ishmaelite, the people that their enemy, they sold him to their enemies. But this is where I'm going to. He was crying. From there, he finds himself in the house of Potiphar. When he got to that place, thinking that he's settling down, then something starts again. Crying starts, pain starts, labor starts, blackmail starts. But let me tell you, he hold on. Maybe I'm talking to you, maybe something like that is happening to you at work. You know, where people blackmail you, they have evidence or something they set you up to do, and you'll be crying. Maybe it's in your marriage, and you'll be crying. Maybe it's over your children, you've been crying, but I have a good news for you. That same Joseph that cried when everybody set him up became Joseph that smiled when everybody saw him smiling. The people that made him to cry, when they came back to him, they became people who, I just thank God for life of Joseph. That's why I'm sharing this message today, that somebody who is listening to this message, maybe you've been in a situation where the men blackmail you and they have evidence against you and you see yourself crying. Joseph wept. After crying, his life turned around. If you go with me to the book of Genesis, chapter 43, verse 30, is where I just want to stand to share with somebody today. 30 said, and Joseph made haste, for his bones did yearn upon his brothers, and he sought where to weep. And he entered into his chamber and wept there. There are some private tears that you don't want anybody to see when you are weeping. If there are some people who have hurt you beyond your expectation, you have nobody to complain to, you have nobody to talk to, but let me tell you, you know what? Doesn't matter how they have provoked you. Sarah one time cried privately. Hannah one time cried because of provocation of her maid Penina. But upon all this private cry, you know, God knows how to wipe away your tears. And speaking to somebody who is being on issue, who is weeping right now, who his heart or her heart is broken, I want you to know that our God, who who make you, who saw you crying in pain is about to bring you out to cry for joy. Because Joseph, as we can see, he cried because of what the brother did. He cried because the brothers thought they sold him. He cried because the brother they betrayed him. He cried because he find himself in the house of Potiphar, where he thought that everything is working well. The Potiphar's wife came up with all kinds of blackmail. He cried when he was in prison after all that crying. Everything that he cries speaks for him. I said to somebody today, you be crying, but I'm here to declare to you today that you will no more cry for pains, but you will begin to cry for joy, because two things can make you cry. I see some people, when they see stars, they will both start crying. If the good thing happen to them, they will start crying. If they receive good news, they will start crying. If they see something that surprised them, that they least expected, they will start crying. And that's the area the Lord is taking you to this season. Season to cry, season of surprise, season that you will begin to see God turn your life around, bring you to a place of testimony. Child of God, I say, weep no more, for the Lord is with you. The Lord, he is with you, he's mighty, he's not an ordinary God. It's God that said to us that weeping come for a night, but in the morning come the joy. I come this morning, to this day, to declare over your life as a servant of God that the Lord whom I serve is bringing you to a place of joy, and you will have reason to testify. That sister who has been married for some time, who has been crying, looking at other women, even some deliberately use it on her, that when are you going to have your own children? I said to you, God will soon put laughter in your mouth. That brother who has been working so hard that to settle in the land where the Lord planted him. But if not settle, and you'll be crying, you'll be saying, Lord, if you are indeed the one that sent me, I see the Lord bringing laughter for you. There is a good news coming for you. I don't know if your cry is for doctor's report, but I see the Lord turning it around. There will be a testimony. There will be a joy coming to you. I mean, one of my daughters went to hospital, and they said to her, one of my spiritual daughters went to hospital, and they told her that she had cancer, that she's going to die. Doctor even gave her 6 months to prepare. But I said to her, I said, daughter, that is doctor's report. The report of the Lord says, let the weak say I'm strong. Let the sick say I'm healed. Declare it every morning. And to God be the glory today. 5 years is gone. She is living. And she's bouncing in the Lord. She will not die, because the enemy brought tears that day through the doctor's report to her that you will die. But when God turned around, I mean, when she cried to God, God turned the matter around. When she go to hospital now, they call her miracle woman. How did it happen? I said to her, it's the word of God. It's God himself who did it. It's not any man. I see God removing every spiritual cancer in your life that has been eating up your destiny, that has been bringing pains to you, that has been making you to gather but never gather, that has been making you to stand but never stand, that has been making you to laugh but never laugh. It's like your laugh has been a plastic. It's like your laugh, you can count how many times you laugh in your life, but I see the ocean of joy coming back unto you because of what the Lord will do. Somebody, the Lord will visit you. There is joy coming. Your joy is coming. Your season of weeping is over. Your season of laughter is today. You step into it. We just finished Easter, and Jesus Christ has resurrected, because he resurrected in the grave. When he was there, he said, whatever that is holding you, let go. Let go. The Bible says he came and said the captive is free. Everything that is holding you, everything that is suppressing you, everything that is bringing you down, I declare as a servant of God that your joy is coming, because of by the order of God's intervention, your joy is coming, your peace is coming, the glory of God over your life shall be restored. No man can hijack your glory, and no man will shine with your glory, for I know that I know we serve a big God. Child of God, your joy is coming. Weep no more. Your season of weeping is over. The Bible said, in that 30, that was what happened. He saw his brothers. His heart was broken. I'm preaching from Genesis 43, maybe just tuning in. From Genesis 43, verse 30. When his brothers saw him, they never knew who he was. People who have hurt you that made you to cry, when God's grace come upon you, when they see you, they will never recognize you. When God, oh my God, I just said to somebody, listen, weep no more. I could see a woman who is sitting opposite me, who is crying. She'll be crying for almost up. Your name is Elena. You've been crying for days and days and days because of disappointment you got, because of pains that men has dropped over your life, because of people who you trusted have betrayed you. But child of God, cry no more. Because every betrayer takes you to your destiny. Every time men bring tears to your eyes, if you run to Christ, he will wipe away that tears and put joy. That's why the Bible says in the book of Isaiah 61, he said that the Spirit of God is upon me. He has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has anointed me to speak to heal the brokenhearted, to bring trashes, to turn spirits of mourning into spirit of praise. The garment of sorrow to the garment of joy. I see somebody, the Lord is turning your life to his glory. Joy is coming. Weeping for night, your night is ending. Every night must end. There is no night that longer, more than even in winter, no matter how long the night starts. One day, the day will come. I see your day coming. I see the Lord restoring every pain. I see the Lord restoring joy. Dear woman who is been crying over her children, I say to you, weep no more. For those children, the grace of God will reach them. And men who know them before, who look at you, cry and blame you, who look at you and say that, oh, look at, find all kinds of fault. You know, when men are going through situations, people will come up with all kinds of excuses, tell them this happened, that happened, you didn't do this, you didn't do that. But let me tell you, that weeping is for a moment. It will never be for life. For I see Jehovah God turning it around for you. There is a turnaround coming upon your life, coming upon your children, coming upon your family, the family that know for be weeping, the family that God turning it around. There is joy coming upon your life. There is testimony coming. You will rejoice. You will testify. When Penina was working against Hannah, the Bible said she did everything to make Hannah to flee, that Hannah may flee from her home. The Bible said that Hannah every time was weeping. But when God remembered Hannah, Hannah became her weeping tongue to a weeping song. That means anybody that hear her song was touched because of the weeping. Let me tell you, child of God, at times God permit men to betray you. At times God permit pains to come in your life. At times God permit things that bring tears in your life. That so that you can know that there is a God. So that you can know nobody can stop him. So that you can know forever and ever his word remains settled. He said, what can separate us in the book of Romans chapter 8? Verse 29 said to us, is there anything impossible? He said, is there with God all things are possible. With him, everything is possible. With him, the things that are bringing tears to you will turn to joy. With him, when he step in, your tears turn to tears of miracle or tears of worship. I decree from today, somebody who is been weeping, every time weeping, you weep over your marriage, you weep over your husband, you weep over your wife. God has sent me today to come and speak to you in this hour of hope season that your weeping is turning around to joy, for joy in Jesus' name. Your weeping is turning around for joy. Your weeping shall turn for joy. Weep no more, dry your tears. For the Bible says that Jesus wept on the cross. When he wept, what did he do? He wept and called upon the name of the Lord. I said, Lord, why have thou forsaken me? At times we think God has forsaken us, but God can never forsake us, child of God. Weep no more. For our God reign. Weep no more. For Jesus Christ, he's still on the throne. You may look at situation of things. You may look at condition of things. Maybe they sack you from work. Maybe you have not gotten anywhere. Maybe you look left and right. You don't see where to turn to. Child of God, in this hour of hope, I bring hope to you. I bring hope by the power of the Holy Ghost. I said there is hope coming. I said there is
Hi, Chioma Emmanuel is my name from Grace Ministry, where God turned trashes into treasure. I'm inviting you to be my guest. Come and worship with us and enjoy what God is doing in this church. And I promise you, you will not be disappointed. A place where God turned trashes into treasures from zero to hero. And God will get you to that place. Come and experience the undiluted word of God. God bless you. Thank you so much.
You That will be your portion. I decree and declare today that in the name of Jesus, that everything that has been bringing tears into your eyes, my God, Father, I decree that, Lord, you will wipe away tears. Father, wipe away the tears of your children, that woman who has been crying over her husband, who the husband is gone by a friend of his, that crying today of betrayal of husband, crying betrayal of wife, of best friend, that my God is going to wipe away your tears. My sister, weep no more. I want to drop three things with you. Haman betrayed Mordecai. What happened? He ended up in Gallo. When Ahithophel betrayed David, what happened? He ended up committing suicide. What happened when Judas Iscariot betrayed Jesus? He ended up killing himself. I wonder the face. What a face would he have been when now the Joseph brothers get to realize that Joseph is their brother. I wonder what face will Potiphar's wife now used to see, or the ear she will hear with, that Joseph, that they betrayed, that she lied on, that he blackmailed and put him in prison, that today now is the second in command. I ask that God's grace shall speak for you. This hour of hope, I decree and declare that in this very time, this hour for you, I say, weep not, in Jesus' mighty name, that the Lord whom I serve. Genesis 43, this is what he said from verse 1 to 2. He said, and the famine was sore in the land, and it came to pass when he had eaten up the corn which they had brought out of Egypt, their father said unto them, go again, buy us a little food. You see, when they were going, their father said to them, the brothers of Joseph said, go again. The father of Joseph, their brother, said, their father sent the brother, said, go again, buy us a little food. When they went this time, only to them to find out that the Bible said that Joseph knew them, but they never knew Joseph. And when Joseph saw them, Joseph cried. He cried for joy. And then eventually after, when Joseph could not hide himself, Joseph now come out and cried openly where they are. There are people who have put you down. The grace of God will bring you in their presence. That way they will not be able to understand or to know you or to say this is who you are. But when God's grace begins to manifest, child of God, I want to say something to you. Don't hold it against them. Because every disappointment that men disappoint you, turns to appointment. Every weeping, every tears that drop from a child of God. There was a time, you know, when we started ministering, you know, there are people that I met, and oh my God, I so much love them. I believe that everybody was after the kingdom of God. And whatever, you know, so I let them open my pulpit. They were bringing people, anybody they had, they come here and say, yes, let them come. So, you know, even to the extent that I let them have their way. But if, do you know, the same people who were doing this within the church, calling people who they notice that are faithful in the church, and tell them to come and meet me, to discharge them, to release them, so that they can come and work for them. You know what? I look at it and I cried. I said, Lord, this is people I trusted most. And that's why the Bible says anyway, the arm of man will fail you, but Jesus will never fail you. That's why he said to us, what better him that put his trust in a man? But the trust I put in a man that time, but you know what the Lord did? He used it to train me. He used it to train me, to make me to know that it's not about any man, it's all about him. Child of God, it's not about brothers of Joseph, but with brothers of Joseph, their disappointment, what did he do? He helped Joseph to get to his destiny. Then I was running up and down, run to people, run to man, instead of running to God, until God said to me, listen, what are you doing? I have called you. I did not call man. I did not call you with not everybody. I did not call you. The people you are carrying yourself, dropping yourself to, they are not the people I call you for. I called you for for broken hearted. I call you for trashes that they may turn to treasure. I call you to feed on my feet. I call you that as you keep kneeling before me, nations will seek you. And today I bless God for what the Lord is doing. But at that time I thought it's man. I thought I can't do it with your people. The only person you cannot do with child of God is you are God. It's not man. Learn how to depend on him. Learn how to follow him. The brothers of Joseph, they came. The same people who has gone to sold him. It's the same people who now came looking for food from him. He was in a place of abundance. They are coming from a place of famine. People who betray you always remain in famine. I decree and declare that you will not remain in famine. Because they will remain in famine. They will never progress because he said, every child of God, any tear you drop. That's why I say to people, be careful, never you hurt any human being. Because anybody you hurt, you will pay for it. Let us pray. Great and mighty God, we thank you, O Lord, for your word. Father, we bless you because your word go forth and accomplish its purpose. Father, visit every hearer and meet them to their needs. And every declaration that I've made, Father, Lord, you say you will confirm the word of your servant. Father, Lord, I bless you. Confirm the word, O Lord, by answering them, by wiping away their, by wiping away their tears in their eyes. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise.
Hi, Chama Emmanuel is my name. First of all, I thank all of you who has been partnering with us. I'm so grateful. Thank you so much. Today I'm looking for more new partners because more projects, more expenses, please. I want you to partner with us. If you want to partner with us in our kitchen, Grace Kitchen, or you want to partner with us in our TV program that is covering globally, please also partner with us. God be bless you for being a partner. And I'm going to send you one of these books, Empowerment. This book is good. It's a book done by me and Bishop Nwachukwu, powerful book. And this is one of my latest books. It's another nice, beautiful book. This book is called My Redeemer Living. If you partner with me, I will send you the two books. And God bless you, even as you partner with us. Even though I don't have nothing to give you, God will give you. Remember, Jesus said, I was sick. Did you visit me? I was hungry. Did you feed me? I was naked. Did you clothe me? I was in the prison. Did you come to see me? And you say, when did all this happen? You say, when you do it to people who are in that position, you say, you turn it for me. Child of God, we are doing all this. Support us and God will support you. Thank you.